Hi, my name is Aaron Powell. I'm a principal cloud advocate at Microsoft, and in this video, we're going to have a look at how we can declare variables in JavaScript. In JavaScript, there are three ways in which we can declare variables, using three different keywords: var, let, and const. And each of these will operate in a slightly different way, so it's a good idea that we understand the different ways that we can use those variables and the reason we might want to use the type of keyword to define a variable. First up, we have the var keyword. Var has been around the longest. It was the original way that we defined variables in JavaScript. And var is a function scoped variable declaration. That means that the variable, when defined, is available anywhere within that function. It's even available before you might have thought you've declared it, because it's available throughout that entire function scope. This means that if you defined a variable on, say, line 10 of a function, it's actually available on line 1. The other thing with the var keyword is that the variable can be changed within the scope, meaning it's a mutable variable type. We can reassign it, we can change its data type, or anything like that that we might want to do. This makes var a very flexible, but also a potentially dangerous way to declare variables. The next type of variable declaration we've got is the let keyword. Let is similar to var, except that it is block scoped instead of function scoped. This means it's only available with inside of a block, which is denoted by the open and closed curly brackets that your variable was defined in. It's also only usable after the declaration. So unlike var, where the variable is always available with inside of the scope that it's defined in, let is only available from that line down. So if you define a variable using let as a keyword on line 10, it will only be usable from line 10 onwards. Let is also a mutable variable type, which means that you can change it, its value, its type, etc., while it's inside of its block scope. But once it's outside of that scope, the variable is no longer available, so you can reuse that variable name. Finally, we have const. Const is similar to let in that it's a block scope variable, and it's only usable after its declaration. But the difference with const to let is that it can only be assigned, it cannot be reassigned. So once you've set a value to a variable that's defined as a const, meaning a constant value, you cannot change what that assignment is. So you might be wondering, when would you use one variable type compared to another? Well, the recommendations is that you use the const variable type as often as you can. It's the one you should go to first, because this helps you when you come back and look at your own code, or helps other people when they're looking at your code to understand that this variable, it doesn't get reassigned. It's only ever going to be the value that you see it being assigned to initially, and it'll be that the whole time. This is useful to ensure that you have less chances for bugs happening because a variable is being reassigned that you might not be aware of. Let is still very useful though. You would use let with inside of a loop, because this is inside of a block scope where you want to create a new variable each time that loop happens and assign it a new value. Otherwise, if it was a constant, you wouldn't be able to reuse it and reassign it for each iteration of that loop and reuse that variable name. There's no necessary reason to use var anymore, because let and const can cover off pretty much all of the use cases, and they also remove some of the issues that we can have with a var-based variable declaration, particularly the fact that it's usable wherever you've got within inside of your scope and not just within inside of where you thought it was available from.